Introduction to calculus. What is calculus? We'll get to that in a moment. How about when was it discovered? Where did it come from? Well, in the mid-1600s, Isaac Newton went ahead and discovered calculus at the age of 24. And when he discovered calculus, he was really writing a book called La Principia, which is called The Natural Principal Elements. And in that book, it had more new math and science than the sum total of all of humanity had put forth up until that moment. And not bad for a 24-year-old kid. In the second volume, he talks about the motions of the planets around the sun. And to justify it, this is where calculus was born. He develops the math. But he waits to publish, and Leibniz over in Germany, who studies and discovers calculus on his own, publishes first. So you and I are looking at all the notation that Leibniz had done. None of Newton's notation shows up. Now, you ask yourself a very fundamental question here, which is, what is calculus? It's hard to give an intuitive definition, but I can give you an intuitive notion of it. You're driving on the highway, you're going 55 miles an hour, and what happens? You look down at a given instant, that's the key, instant, remember that, and you're going 55 miles an hour. You just said that. I know, but the key is the word instant, because at a given instant, you're not moving. Now think about that. If you're not moving, how can you be traveling 65 miles per hour at that instant? And it is the notion of limits that gets us past this. What we do is we take a look at smaller and smaller average rates of change, smaller and smaller time intervals of a ratio of distance over time. This I can show you in the real world in which we live. How can I do that? What I can do is say that hair, something we all have, grows a half an inch a month. Now let's shorten the time frame. The cheetah, great land animal, runs 70 miles per hour. Shorten the time frame even more. Our rainforest, well, we have 3 football fields of rainforest that we lose to deforestation every minute. Let's shorten the time frame even more. Snowflakes, they fall 3 feet per second. And if you want a really short time frame, an average rate of change that approximates an instant, how about going to the billionth of a second, where the speed of light travels 1 foot per nanosecond. Now we use this notion of a limit of creating these infinitesimal small changes to answer other questions, like what is the area beneath a curve? Well, we know the area of a rectangle is length times width, so we could divide up these areas under the curve into rectangles that touch the curve. And if my length was the distance up to the curve f of x and the width was delta x, if I add up the sum of delta x times f of x for each of the rectangles, it would give an approximate area under the curve if I used 4 rectangles. I can do this by using 16 rectangles, and you can see I get a better approximation. Let's continue this notion of limits and look at approximation with 32 rectangles. We can see how small the error is. And finally, 64 rectangles. The study of limits begins our study of the introduction of calculus.